So you once are in the Neverhood on a modern operating system. As you're about to find that this is not very fun. Okay, so I have the game loaded here. Double click it. No auto run. Okay, so I double click on the setup. This app can't run on your PC. It shouldn't be unexpected, as the Neverhood was obviously not built with Windows 10 in mind. So you hit close, you go, ugh. Then you go over to Steam or good old games, type in the Neverhood, and woo, it's not there. I mean, unless you're talking about Armicrog, the ho-hum spiritual successor. So what are you going to do? Set up a virtual machine? That's too much time. I've seen some guides that say you can go over to the setup, maybe copy some files, the data, copy some more files, mess with your registry, and then boom! Well, bang! La, 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 la. The game will be running fine. Except for the fact that it clearly doesn't. Well, the game itself runs fine. It's the cutscenes, which you're definitely going to want to watch, are going to run like absolute garbage. So, what you should do instead of that lousy method is go to your data folder, copy all 7 of these BLB files, create another folder, maybe on your desktop, or in my case, your OneDrive, and then paste them in. Now, for this method to work, you have to have ScumVM. Now, if you don't know what ScumVM is, it's an, I guess, open source emulator for old adventure games. It's on a variety of platforms, from the 3DS, the DS, the PSP, Dreamcast, you have to homebrew all of those, but who gives a damn, to the Android. A lot of platforms support this, many if you hack into them, but it is a good platform. Now what you're going to want to do is look for the folder you created and hit choose. Now as you see here, it's all set up for you. You don't need to change the name, you don't need to change the ID, it recognizes it all. You can maybe click or uncheck some of the settings here, because they might be helpful to you. Then you can just hit OK, and then start once you have it selected. And ooh, it's working perfectly fine. As you're about to see, the cutscenes, which don't really work that well in the other methods, work perfectly fine here. Look at this, look at how smooth this is. Mwah. I used to play this a lot as a kid. So, the game runs perfectly fine. If you really want to play the Neverhood, like if you've been yearning to play it for the first time or to revisit it, this is the best way to do it. Best way. Doesn't take too much time, doesn't take too much money, I mean, unless you're looking for an actually legitimate copy, which, good luck with that. That's not a very easy task. So, yeah, the game runs fine. I'm rambling here, so I'm gonna end the video.